my opponent's first claim was that nuclear power is more energy efficient, but I wanted to point out that it's not economically efficient because as of right now, 61% of the energy generated in California comes from natural gases, according to the California Energy Commission, and it's not economically efficient because there's competing sources of power that we can use that we're already using right now. And the problem with nuclear power is it costs more. The startup costs more to build a plant, and it costs more to maintain because of all the safety precautions that they take in handling uranium. Another thing my opponent pointed out was that you have to dispose of uranium in a certain way, in all kinds of radioactive waste in a certain way, so it doesn't contaminate surrounding life. But the problem with that is that you have to know how to do it correctly, or else it's gonna affect the surrounding life. His second claim was that California currently has laws in place that make nuclear power a less feasible choice. And I think what he's trying to say when he says that is that there aren't a lot of subsidies for nuclear power as are for coal, wind, or solar energy. And the reason for that is because as of right now, natural gas is at a very low price, more than it has been in recent years. And that's because the government provides a lot of subsidies for natural gas and other forms of power and clean energy, as opposed to nuclear power, because that's still a debatable source of power. It's also cheaper to operate wind and solar and other clean energy alternatives as opposed to nuclear, because it's easier to start a mining operation or a solar operation or a clean energy operation as it is to a nuclear operation, because first there's the startup costs of nuclear energy, and there's also a huge price for dismantling them when they no longer run efficiently. It's natural gas, and the reason that it's in high demand is because so far it has been reaching California's energy efficiency standards. And another thing my opponent said was that we're running out of resources, but the problem with nuclear power is we're also running out of resources for uranium because we can only mine it in certain places, and it's not a renewable source of energy as opposed to solar or wind or water power. And a study finds that a diverse portfolio of clean energy technologies, except for nuclear, are more feasible pathway to low emission energy system, according to the Climate Nexus. And another problem with nuclear energy is that it takes fossil fuels to mine it out of the ground, because like I mentioned before, uranium isn't found just anywhere. You have to take time to mine it out, and then you have to take time to build the reactors, and you have to take time to pay people who know what they're doing, as opposed to other forms of energy where it's more anyone could get that job. Several reactors have already failed and were shut down, and they take up valuable land space. They contaminate surrounding areas, and they take money out of programs that could have been used to make for clean energy sources. During the last wave of nuclear power plant construction in the United States, the capital cost far exceeded the benchmark that was set in place to make and start up nuclear power plants. And since the 2000s, the anticipated costs of the new nuclear power plants have more than tripled, according to the Chief of Nuclear Energy Institute. And another thing that my opponent said was that in other places, they're already utilizing nuclear power, but in a past story that they said that India was developing thorium reactors, and when they were doing the fission that they do in uranium to make nuclear power, that there was complications with it, and that the waste from that fission leaked into the surrounding area, and that was in May 2016. And in Japan, their government has already spent over $100 billion in U.S. dollars to clean up the efforts related to the Fukushima nuclear waste incident, and it's projected that it's gonna cost another $300 billion U.S. dollars to clean it up.